Everyone's talking about AI search engines. ChatGPT, Gemini, Perplexity, and so many more. But which is truly the best? Which gives you the fastest, most accurate, and least biased answers when it matters most? I asked 28 questions from Who Won Wimbledon 2025 to explain blockchain with a pizza analogy to 9 different search engines. They are ChatGPT, DeepSeek, Google Gemini, Perplexity, Claude, Grok, NDSearch, Copilot Search, and U.com. And let me tell you, I faced some serious ups and downs. Like when U.com locked me out of its pro search after just 3 searches, forcing me to create a ridiculous number of Gmail accounts just to keep going, and many more. I'll review them to you as I run those tests. This video is all about testing these AI search engines to learn if they can access recent data, how biased they are, how fast they can produce an output, can they simplify complex concepts, and most importantly, how accurate they are. These are the 28 questions we will be asking, and let's cut to the first. Our goal for this test was to know if these AI search engines can handle fresh, breaking information, so I started with a simple question. Who won Wimbledon 2025? DeepSeek failed at first, it only had data up to June 2024, but after enabling its search mode, it finally found the right answer. I wish it had been smarter about that from the start. While for Gemini 2.5 Pro, well, it gave me placeholders instead of real results. I might as well add my name. Anyway, it was only when I switched to Gemini 2.5 Flash did it finally work. And the good news? Perplexity, ChatGPT, U.com, and the rest nailed it on the first try. The next question was, what was Tesla's stock price yesterday? But the problem was, currently it is Monday in Singapore, and in the US it is still Sunday. So yesterday was Saturday, and the stock market was not open. Surprisingly, all the AI search engines were able to provide accurate answers. And when I asked the third question, what was the score between Seoul and Ulsan in the K-League 1 on 20 July 2025, which was a few days ago? And I thought some AI search engines might not be able to provide the answer because it was a niche query. But surprisingly again, they all provided accurate answers, with Copilot Search being more enthusiastic than the rest, with all the additional highlights and playing styles. So with everyone performing so well, there is got to be something that differentiates them. So I thought of this question that is not only niche but also requires search engines to get information from a local site. The query was, list all movies playing at Singapore GV theaters this week.
What?
So what can I do but to complain and set up a new Google account for that? I think I'm on their watch list right now. I got a big break. Claude, Grok, NDSearch, and Copilot all struggled to provide any credible output. Why? Maybe because they were not scraping real-time sources for localized data. They mostly relied on index knowledge or summaries instead of live feeds. But hold on, I went to the GV website and there were 28 movies showing right now. And comparing it to ChatGPT, there were no movies called 3BHK, Salvable, and this movie. So out of 28, it got 12 correct. DeepSeek nailed 10. Perplexity showed movies that were no longer playing, such as the Minecraft movie, Snow White, Nerda, and many others, but nailed 4. And impressively, U.com nailed 19, and Google Gemini nailed 20. These are all going into the scorecard for accuracy. But for now, I would say for recency, Google Gemini and U.com scores 9 out of 10 stars. ChatGPT and DeepSeek scores 8. And for the rest, unfortunately, I've got to score them 7. The next is the biasness test. We want to test if the AI search engines will lean towards one side or the other, or if they will stay neutral. So we ask questions like, is nuclear energy better than renewable energy? And they all provided neutral answers, giving pros and cons and providing objective assessments. The same goes for questions like, should social media platform be regulated? Is AI replacing human creativity? And surprisingly, which is better, Google Gemini or ChatGPT? I seriously thought ChatGPT and Gemini would cite their own platform, but they didn't.
Don't cry, don't cry, don't cry, don't cry, don't cry.
At this point, I realized these AIs are more diplomatic than politicians. Even when I asked, is capitalism better than socialism? They all said the same thing. Mixed systems works best. No one wanted to pick a side. Now I'm getting bored and I'm wondering if I'm doing this right. I gotta turn up the heat. And I thought of this. Should I buy an iPhone or an Android phone? Choose only one. And guess what? ChatGPT and Grok chose Android, while the rest chose iPhone. It's like AI has already joined the Apple cult, except ChatGPT and Grok. So now, I nailed one, but I need another definitive question, so I ask a political question. Which political system is better, democracy or authoritarianism? But luckily, I figured out that I can switch the AI mode to Express, so I can use the AI search freely. Guess what? 7 out of 9 said the same thing. Democracy tends to outperform authoritarianism over the long run. Google Gemini stayed balanced, but Grok gave the most nuanced answer, citing Scandinavia as a democracy success story and Singapore as a case for authoritarian efficiency. So I guess you know how I would score this. In terms of biasness, Grok scored the best for being neutral, followed by Gemini, and the rest are pretty biased if you want them to be. Next, I want to test how well the AI search engines can take a difficult topic and explain it in layman's terms. In other words, dumb it down for me. I thought ChatGPT would perform well in this. But to my surprise, a question like, explain blockchain using a pizza delivery analogy. ChatGPT explained it in a way that is too complicated. Why wouldn't the pizza shop record the order immediately, but instead wait to group the orders into a block? And for the others, they did well. I was able to understand the concept of the blockchain after reading them. And when I asked about quantum computing, ChatGPT again failed to dumb it down. And it is hard to grasp the concept because it didn't relate well with a layman. And for the rest, it was pretty easy to understand. Just for you to know, I am not biased. I love ChatGPT, by the way. So in terms of analogy and simplification, I would say ChatGPT is the only one who didn't perform well. Now, the most important test of all is the accuracy test. So I started with something easy. Is there an official announcement of the release of the Apple M5 chip? And every AI search engine can accurately say there is no official announcement, just speculations. I continue to ask questions like, who won the 2024 Nobel Prize in Physics? What is Japan's GDP in 2024? Which year did Singapore gain independence? What is the capital of Australia? When was ChatGPT first launched? And even which city is planned to be the capital of Indonesia by 2045? Which I thought was a tough question. But all AI search engines accurately answered them. I gotta find some discrepancies, so I asked, what was the score between Manchester United and Aston Villa on May 25th, 2025? And who scored? All others were able to provide accurate information and additional context, but Gemini 2.5 Flash provided just the score but missed on who is the scorer. So, I asked another soccer-related question, such as who won the recent English Premier League? And again, all were able to provide accurate answers, but Gemini provided me with a list of past matches that meant nothing. I guess Gemini dislikes soccer queries, what do you think? Anyway, I needed a query where I can assess their ability to accurately summarize published information. So I asked the AI search engines to summarize the key points of the latest AI Act in Europe 2025. And let me tell you, this wasn't an easy task. We spent a lot of time doing this, so if you can do us a favor and smash that thumbs up, we'll be truly grateful. Anyway, we went through all the outputs provided by the AI search engines and carefully listed every piece of information as a checkbox in a spreadsheet, and made sure that whatever that was mentioned by each search engines were noted. And by the end, we tabulated their scores out of 30, because there were 30 items mentioned. To our surprise, Claude performed the worst, as it oversimplified. Andy Search and Copilot Search were tied at the bottom spots, and above them were DeepSeek and Gemini, and right above them were Perplexity. Now, we are left with ChatGPT, Grok, and You.com, and I was shocked when I tabulated the results. The first place was not ChatGPT, nor was it Grok, it was You.com. Grok clinched the second place and ChatGPT was in the third place. Now, this test wasn't enough. We needed something to solidify our findings. So we asked the AI search engines to share with us what AI tools were announced at Google I.O. 2025. And we read, compared and fact-checked the results to the 100 things that were announced in Google I.O. 2025. And this was our findings. The most surprising was You.com. It performed the best in our previous test, but now it performed the worst by naming the least number of tools. Although it didn't make a mistake, but it only mentioned 12 tools. And then Claude mentioned one tool more than You.com. And above them were DeepSeek, which made one mistake by mentioning a tool that was not announced, and Andy Search, which didn't make a mistake. Copilot Search was right above them, followed by Perplexity. The top contender for this round was Google Gemini, with ChatGPT and Grok tied. So with these two tests, we can somewhat determine that the most consistent and accurate AI search engines are Grok, ChatGPT, and Google Gemini. But it is still too early to tell. We have one more test, which is the most painstaking part of the test. We want to know how fast the AI search engines can provide an answer. For AI search engines like NDSearch, we had to start the timer when we entered a search query and pause it when we found search results. We will start the timer again when we click on a button for the AI to read, analyze, and stop the timer when the text started to generate. For the rest, we start the timer as soon as we submit the query and stop it when the first text starts showing. And this is what we found. They are all recorded in seconds if you are wondering. After painstakingly timing the 28 queries on 9 AI search engines, we found that U.com is the slowest of all on average. And then if you have used DeepSeek, you know it is slow as well, especially when a query requires it to search the web. NDSearch is a little faster than DeepSeek, and Copilot stands above ND. And then Claude is a little faster than Copilot. Now, these are the AI search engines that produce results at an average of below 3.5 seconds, which are considered very fast. But coming in 4th place is Perplexity at 3.32 seconds. ChatGPT is in the 3rd place at 3.14 seconds, and between Gemini and Grok, Gemini is the winner by 0.3 seconds. So it's time to put everything together. Remember, we are only using the free version of each AI search engine, so the results cannot be conclusive. And at the same time, we are not here to put any tools down, but to share with you our findings based on countless sleepless nights of research and analysis. So here we go. There were a total of 5 tests, and for each test, we have scored them based on 10 stars, so the full marks will be 50. In terms of recency, Gemini and U.com scored the best, followed by DeepSeek and the rest. For biasness, remember Grok was the most objective, Gemini was neutral, and the rest were a little biased. For simplification and analogy, ChatGPT could have done better. Now for accuracy, which is the most important test, we have consolidated all the test results and Grok was consistent throughout, followed by ChatGPT and Gemini. Perplexity and U.com were close, Copilot and DeepSeek were tied, and Claude unfortunately performed the worst. Based on speed, Grok and Gemini were at the 2 second mark, so they deserve 10 stars. Perplexity and Grok were at the 3 second mark, so 9 stars for them. And here's the rest of the scores. And finally, here's the final score. Let me sort them accordingly. So as you can see, Grok and Gemini are tied, but looking at the scores, I would say Grok is consistent throughout. So if I were to pick one, I would say Grok is number one. Now, although ChatGPT is at a 3rd place, I think it is pretty consistent throughout as well. So the funny thing here is the Android lovers are at the top, while Gemini leads the iPhone pack. Now, there are 4 questions that were not factored into the test because 2 of the queries were math questions and all the search engines performed well, so there is nothing to compare. And the 2 others were supposed to test their predictive capabilities, but after some thought, we think there is no way to conclusively tell if the predictions are accurate, so we scrapped them. I hope you understand. So, what do you think about our analysis? Which are the AI search engines you would use? Let us know in the comments down below, and don't forget to smash that thumbs up. Our channel is all about helping you grow your search traffic, and if you haven't subscribed to us yet, consider doing so. This is Jack from RingMath. I'll see you in the next video.